Hello everyone. Today in cell biology, we will be discussing about the ultrastructure and functions of lysosomes. Okay. Now, a brief introduction regarding the ultrastructure and functions of the lysosomes. The lysosomes are the tiny membrane-bound vesicles involved in intracellular digestion. Since they are involved in the process of intracellular digestion, the lysosomes inside them consist of what are known as the hydrolytic enzymes. Okay, so these hydrolytic enzymes, they function under optimum pH around 5, that is the acidic pH. Okay, and this optimum pH inside the lysosomes is maintained by the active proton pumps, that is the ATP driven proton pumps that are present on the lysosomal membrane. Then what is the main function of the lysosomes? The lysosomes are meant for digestion, intracellular digestion, and also secondarily they cause aging and death of animal cells. Now if you look at how the lysosomes are formed inside the cell, now the major origin from where the lysosomes are formed start from the endoplasmic reticulum and then to the Golgi apparatus. From the trans-Golgi, the vesicles are formed. The vesicles which are formed gets coated with the receptors of methyl-6-phosphate, and that results in formation of lysosomal vesicles. Okay, so the fresh lysosomal vesicles that are formed from the trans-Golgi are known as the primary lysosomes. Now, if you look at the picture of the lysosome here, you can see they have taken the cross section, and inside there is presence of what are known as the hydrolytic enzyme mixture. There are varieties of enzymes that are present inside the lumen of the lysosome, and you can see the membrane here. It is quite a distinct type of membrane that we see in the lysosome. Especially the lysosomal membrane is very well glycosylated. That means it is coated with the carbohydrates. This is very, very essential for protecting the membrane from the lysosomal enzymes. Okay, so there's a special character, and there are also lipids that are present. These are essential to make the lysosomal vesicles fuse with the other vesicles. All this we shall be discussing later. As of now, you understand the lumen of the lysosome, there are hydrolytic enzymes, and this is the membrane. The membrane's special character is the membrane is highly glycosylated, and there is a lipid bilayer that is present. All this results in formation of a unit membrane. Now, this is the chemical composition that they have shown in this cartoon. So you can see in the lumen, there are various hydrolytic enzymes that are present, proteases, lipases, etc. And you can also see the presence of what is known as the V-type ATPase and the proton pumps, which maintain the high proton concentration inside the lumen of the lysosome. As a result, the pH will be maintained around 5, which is very, very essential for the functioning of the hydrolytic enzymes of the lysosome. Okay. Now, if you look at the structure of the lysosome, basically the lysosomes are round vacuolar structures, and they have a size of around 0.2 to 0.5 micrometer. You can see this is the picture representing the lysosome. So they have around the size of around 0.5 micrometer, and the inside the lumen there are acid hydrolases. You can see there is presence of the unit membrane. Unit membrane structure we have seen already. There is a lipid bilayer, glycosylated membrane to protect from the lytic enzymes that are present inside lysosomal membrane. And now the lysosomal enzymes, which are present in the lumen, as we have seen already, they are hydrolyte. Which are these enzymes? Proteases, nucleases, glycosidases, lipases, phospholipases, phosphatases, and sulfatases, etc. All these hydrolytic enzymes are present in the lumen, and they all love them together. We term them as hydrolases. Since they function under the pH 5, optimum pH 5, they are termed as acid hydrolases. Now, the special character of the lysosomal membrane is it is resistant to the membrane. It is resistant to the enzymes that are secreted by the lysosome. Now, so if you look at this picture, you can see the luminal pH of the lysosome, which is, it is around 4.5 to 5. It is maintained by the active or proton-driven or ATP-driven proton pumps. I told you, proton concentration is maintained high here. As a result, all the hydrolases can function thoroughly. And along with that, since it plays a role in the digestion, you can see various transporters that are present. Once the digestion process is completed, the products of the digestion, they may be supplied out in or out of the cell for the reutilization or for the destruction. Okay, and various other functions are performed by the lysosome. For that, the receptors we can see on the membrane. Now, if you look at the lysosomal membrane, it is a special kind of membrane, as we have seen in the previous picture, because since the environment inside the lumen of the lysosome, it is different. It is consisting of hydrolytic enzymes. So that is why the lysosomal membrane is thicker than the mitochondrial membrane and contains substantial amount of carbohydrates. So especially the carbohydrate sialic acid. Okay. And I have already told you it is well glycosylated. The membrane, protein membrane, is well glycosylated to protect itself from the lysosomal proteases. And there are also lipids that are present. These lipids are very essential to make the lysosome, primary lysosome, to fuse with the other vesicles. And lysosomal membrane, apart from these characteristics, it has the right transporters for transporting the final product of the lysosomal digestion. This supply is either for the excretion or the reutilization. So this is another picture representing the structure of the lysosome. And based on whether the freshly formed lysosome or is it fused with the other vesicles, we have classified the lysosomes into four different types. Number one, the primary lysosomes. So these are the newly formed lysosomes containing digestive enzymes. And the second type of lysosomes are the heterophagosomes. And they are formed by fusion of primary lysosomes, that's formed by the Golgi operators, with cytoplasmic vesicles. The cytoplasmic vesicles that are formed may be containing a non-functional cell organelle or a food particle. This primary lysosome goes and fuses with that and forms what is known as the heterophagosome. Okay. And another one is the autophagosomes. They are primary lysosomes which are able to digest intracellular structures. Remember, students, the cell may contain some non-functional or old cell organelles like mitochondria, ribosomes, peroxisomes, and the glycogen granules, etc. These are in turn digested by the lysosomes. The lysosome that is digesting these cell organelles, they are termed as the autophagosomes. And finally, sometimes when the digestion inside the lysosomal food vacuole is incomplete, at that time it results in formation of what are known as the residual bodies. Okay, so in this picture you are able to see the cell is undergoing phagocytosis. It is eating or inserting. There is a phagocytosis that is occurring into the cytoplasm. This is the phagosome that is formed, and you can see here the primary lysosome getting formed by the Golgi apparatus. It fuses with the phagosome, resulting in the formation of the phagosome. And I have shown this is a primary lysosome, the star red star mark, and this is the phagosome. The fusion results and the digestion process starts, and if there is any undigested food particle yet remaining, it results in formation of what are known as the residual bodies. And if the lysosome is fusing with the vesicle which is already containing a non-functional or aged cell organelle, it is known as the autophagic vacuole. Okay. Now, in this picture, they are showing clearly autophagosome that is containing the mitochondria non-functional. Now, the lysosome, primary lysosome that is formed by the Golgi apparatus, comes and fuses with the autophagosome. And finally, the hydrolytic enzymes that are present inside the lysosome, they bring about breakdown of the products that are present inside. And the products of the digestion, they will be transported by different different transporters that are present on the membrane of the lysosome. So this picture also explains the functioning of the lysosome. You can see the formation of the phagosome, secondary vesicle, and macroautophagy, where macro cell organelles are digested. And here the microautophagy, you can see, and this is the primary lysosome. Okay. Now, after understanding the structure of the lysosome, let us come to the functions of the lysosome. The major function of the lysosome is digestion of the large extracellular particles. Like, lysosome digests food content of the phagosome. The phagosome is formed by the phagocytosis, and this phagosome gets associated with the primary lysosomes, resulting in digestion. And one of the examples is the lysosomes of the leukocytes allow them to devour the foreign particles. This occurs in the resistance against the foreign particles or the antigens. And second function is the digestion of the intracellular substances. That means when the cell is under starvation, there is no external supply of food, at that time lysosome digests the stored food particles that are present inside the cell. Now autolysis, that means the under pathological condition, when there is some problem with the cell functioning, the lysosome digests various cell organelles. Okay, so in fact, traditionally lysosomes are termed as suicide bags. That's the reason it start devouring or digesting the cell organelles. And apart from that, another important function is this extracellular digestion. The lysosome of certain cells, such as the sperms, discharge their enzymes outside the cell during the process of fertilization. We know very well the fertilization process. The sperm acrosome, it consists of some hydrolytic enzymes that is released. So, like that, some of the lysosomes may also release the enzymes outside. Okay, so these are the functions. And in this picture, you are able to see the lysosome has various functions performing. Okay, so just go through this picture. Thank you all.